Republican Congressman Ryan Costello of Pennsylvania and Democratic Congressman Anthony Brown of Maryland. So I think the key thing we just heard from Senator Kennedy is simply this. I don't know how President Trump feels. And I'm wondering, Congressman Costello, how do you negotiate when you have a president who isn't consistent, who often seems to contradict his staff and has a history of changing his mind?
And in fact, the last time we did a CR, if my recollection serves me correct, we passed it out of the House based on him saying he was going to vote for it. And then the Speaker actually had to go down to the White House the next day to convince him to sign it. I think what's going to happen here is we will pass a short-term fix through February 8th or on around February 8th. There'll be some attachments to this spending bill so that it can't be spent as freely on the wall as the president would like. And then the president's going to say he's going to do with the money whatever he wants. And, you know, everyone will live to fight another day. And it will set up, subsequent to the State of the Union, which I think that this becomes the issue, how will the president frame this in February with the Democrats in the House, and what shape will next year's funding, how will it play out?
Before we get to February, we got to get to the next 2 days, right? And I think, you know, you've got the president tweeting about the wall a lot. This morning, here's what he said. Mexico is paying indirectly for the wall through the new USMCA, the replacement for NAFTA. Far more money coming to the U.S. because of the tremendous dangers at the border, including large-scale criminal and drug inflow. The United States military will build the wall. Sarah Huckabee Sanders said something, you know, pretty similar to that yesterday. Congressman Brown, is this a fundamental lack of understanding about how the budget works? How do you see what they're trying to explain about the wall?
Well, first of all, I say that I think we do understand where the president is on the shutdown. He said last week that he would take pride in a shutdown, notwithstanding that 300,000 to 400,000 federal government employees and their families would suffer through the holidays. I don't think we should be tying the question of funding a wall to a continuing resolution. This debate, this discussion, and whatever decision is made on a border wall or enhanced border security needs to be done in the context of broader immigration discussion, comprehensive immigration reform. We need to take up the question of the Dreamers and those on temporary protective status. We need to talk about the H-series visas and how we strengthen the system to receive those who are seeking asylum in this country. That's how we should be discussing and deciding the border wall, not by attaching it to an end-of-year, midnight, continuing resolution debate.
Well, this sort of midnight, last-minute CR, Congressman Costello, you didn't run for re-election. So as you look at this budget battle right now through a little bit of a different lens than you might have a year or two ago, is this exactly why so many Americans went to the ballot box in November and voted for change? Because they're so frustrated, why does Congress keep kicking the budget can down the road?
Well, I think November was much more about a referendum on the president than anything else. But look, there is an element here. If you recall, you know, when the guy wakes up and it's time to make the donuts, or Bill Murray and Groundhog Day, you know, we feel like we're back here more
again
often than we should.
Again and again and again.
To my colleague's point, he is correct. I agree with him. We should not in isolation tie a CR to a border funding spend. It should be part of broader immigration reform. We tried to do that in the House over the summer. It didn't happen, but DACA, visa reform, and more border security should all be part of one big bill. The problem, as I see it, is we have the far right and the far left creating litmus tests and saying what they will never vote for, rather than saying what they need in order to vote for a broader immigration reform bill.
So those things that haven't gotten done, but Congressman Brown, even though Congress can't get on the same page about immigration, about the border, we did see a pretty big bipartisan move overnight when the Senate passed this pretty big criminal justice reform bill backed by the White House, expanding early release programs. It modifies sentencing laws. It gives judges more discretion over sentences for nonviolent drug offenders and gives us more for rehab programs for former prisoners. Are you going to support this bill? Are you surprised, happy, anything that you want to say about actual bipartisanship on the Hill?
Sure, Chris, it's a much better product coming out of the Senate than what passed out of the House. In fact, I opposed the House version earlier this year. I joined John Lewis, the NAACP, in opposing what the House passed. It didn't go far enough. The Senate version does, as you pointed out. It gives judges discretion to go below the mandatory minimums. It reduces mandatory minimums for a number of drug offenses. It encourages more home detention and community-based restrictions versus incarceration. So it's a much better bipartisan bill.
So you would vote for this bill?
Yeah, I look forward to supporting this bill. Look, it's a first step. We know that there are far too many Americans who are incarcerated, and a disproportionate number of them are young African-American men. So anything that we can do to make progress to reduce the prison population while ensuring public safety, and I think this bill is an incremental step in that direction. We have more work to do, and I look forward in the 116th Congress to continuing that effort.
So, Congressman Costello, in our last 30 seconds, would you vote for this bill, number one? And two, are there any other issues you see realistically in the short term, like criminal justice reform, that parties can come together on?
I will vote for the bill. There is a disparate impact on treatment of those in the criminal justice system, disproportionately and detrimentally impacting African Americans. The issue that I think is most prominent where we could get some bipartisan support for the betterment of our country will be infrastructure. You need to put revenue on the table, though. That's the one area where I think both parties can come together, and it's very hard to do finger pointing when the American people know that we need more for roads and bridges, for energy independence and modernizing our grid, and a couple of, and frankly, if you look at electric vehicles and autonomous vehicles, we need to make sure that technology within the infrastructure is speaking to our transportation system. So yes, that's the one area where I'm optimistic, and I hope it happens.
I like that in the holiday season to end on an optimistic note. Congressman, thank you both so much, and I hope you have a great holiday.